this magic moment.
My wife had never been out there, and she came out. She wanted to go shopping in Beverly Hills because she'd seen it on the Travel Channel. We got this car that they provided us with, and there was this driver who was a real pompous ass. You know, I'm looking at the map. I said, take us to Rodeo Street. He says, it's Rodeo. I said, whatever, ass-hole-ayo, let's just go. We got down there, and I bought her a shoe because I couldn't afford the other one. They don't fuck around on Rodeo Street. We went in that Ralph Lauren shop. He's awful proud of his shit, isn't he? He had a sweater in there for $600. You can get a sweater at Walmart for $13. He had a sweater for $600. I asked this Spanish fella, I said, how come this sweater is $600?
He says, it's cashmere.
A son of a bitch jumped toward me like that, and I went, I thought he's going to fuck me. I did. But he didn't. He didn't, see? I said, well, it might be cashmere, but the price is bullshit. And that scared him because he thought I was going to fuck him, but I didn't. And we went in this restaurant out there to eat, this real fancy place. And I think that's the name of it, real fancy place. And we went in, and I couldn't read the menu because it was written in some sort of foreign language. And I asked the waiter, I said, I can't read this yet. What do you recommend?
And he says, the fish balls.
Now, fish balls at this place are apparently like a hush puppy with fish in them. But when he first said it, I was thinking what you were thinking. Fish balls, I'm going to have to eat a million of those to get full. You ever seen the balls on a fish? They're tiny. You better bring me a whole bunch of them damn things. He just rolled his eyes and walked away. I said, throw in a chicken dick while you're at it. Chicken dick and fish balls on a bed of lettuce. Bring some ketchup. You can make anything taste good with ketchup. They got some weird shit out there. We went in this bar one night, me and my buddy Nick, and there was a fella in there, and he was gay, and I knew he was because he's wearing a T-shirt, said he was. Which I appreciate, because you could spot him. Yeah? There he is, right there. I mean, that cut out a lot of bullshit if we all had a T-shirt, said what we liked on there. I mean, if I had a T-shirt with a big puss, he could see that, and I could say, see, I like that, you like this, and this just ain't gonna work, you just keep on walking. See? So we got back in this back room, me and this guy, Nick, we were playing pool, and Nick left me there. We had one of them uncomfortable moments where you laugh and shut up and then lock eyes, but he locked a little too long, you know. He's like, he says, you know, Rodney, I like you. I said, well, hell, I like you too. He says, you ought to try it. And I said, try what? He said, being gay. I said, I don't think that's something you try. You don't try a dick. You try ice cream. See, at least with ice cream, you taste it, you don't like it, you walk away. There's no long-lasting effect. But I'm almost certain if I tried dick that that would affect me for the rest of my life. I don't think I'd ever have fun ever again. I'd be on a roller coaster with my buddy. Woo! Ain't this great, Rodney? Yeah? I should have never tried that dick. Maybe you should have put ketchup on it. Oh, hell.